سبحان ربي العظيم، سبحان ربي العظيم، سبحان ربي العظيم. Okay, before we go any further, let's take a quick review of what has happened so far. So when you start the prayer, you start with Allahu Akbar. That was our first video, you know, in the series after the introduction. Then you have, you know, seeking protection, which is A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. Okay, now after that, this is the first chapter of Quran. This is what we will work on reciting. That will be in the upcoming episodes. But what I did in the previous episode is I showed you this, right? As you say, see here is beginners. So until you know this, what you can do is you can use this, which we covered in the previous video, while you're standing and, you know, sitting at the end and so on and so forth. Okay. And I would also link this PDF that I'm using in this video's description, as well as in the previous video's description, inshallah. So you would have that. And if you go in the playlist of this videos, you would actually see the app names and whatnot. Okay. So this is what we covered last time. Now, before going into this thing, what I will do is I will cover what we say while we are bowing. And then later on, I will cover what we say while we are prostrating. So in this video, we are talking about this position of bowing. So you say this three times, you can say this five, seven, if you want longer, that's all fine. But minimum, you know, it's good to say it three times, okay? So what this means is you're saying that glory, right? So this is the word subhana. This is something we covered in the previous video as well, which means that Allah, you know, glory, which means to negate any sort of imperfection or deficiency from Allah. Okay, then we have the word Rabb. This is one of the names of Allah, and this is very powerful. In general, in English, people translate it as Lord, but if you really think deeper about it, this means that Allah is the creator. Okay, so anything that we have, you, me, our eyes, our hands, so on and so forth, they are a creation of Allah. Even the phone, right? This phone, for example, car, whatever, these are all creation of Allah. Now, one may say that, hey, you know, well, you know, a human being did it, or Google did it, Samsung, Apple. But if you really think about who created the human beings, and most importantly, where do ideas and research and innovations come from? If you look at the ideas and research history, you will see a lot of times scientists and researchers stumble upon something. You know, so this is something that Allah blesses people with, the raw materials and so on and so forth. And then at the same time, who is the one who's actually facilitating you and I to benefit and to experience that device or that object or that site? Okay, so Allah is the creator. And then we say it also includes the meaning of ownership. So even though in a human sense, look, someone creates this and then you pay them and then you exchange ownership, right? So you give them cash or money or what have you, and then you get the product. But the true owner is Allah, because he's the one who is facilitating all these transactions, all these trades and what have you. So true ownership actually belongs to whom? Allah. So if you wanted to understand from a human example, and Allah is not like any human being, imagine if your father gives you a certain amount of money to use it, right? It's for use. Okay, you know what? You can buy things, or, you know, I'm going to buy you a car or a phone, but I still own the ownership, right? You're driving it, you can take it anywhere, but, you know, I'm giving it to you, right, for you to use. And this also helps us appreciate that when we lose something, you know, whether it be a body part, a relationship, a relative, to remember that it was Allah's blessing that he had given us, he had entrusted us with, to benefit, to enjoy, to utilize, to use, and hopefully in a way that Allah is pleased with. Okay, but if Allah takes it away, something to remember is not focusing on what we lost or what was taken away, but rather that Allah let us have it for years before he took it away. And at the same time, also all the other things that Allah is letting us enjoy and have while he took one or two or three things. Okay, and then finally, it also means that Allah is fully in charge. Allah is the governor of all affairs, right? So now this is a phone that, you know, from a worldly sense, I own it. But, you know, I can't protect it. Somebody can steal it, you know, if Allah allows that to happen, or it can fall down or break. So many different things can happen, right? Or I can lose the power or ability to utilize it, you know, by losing some sort of body part or limb. But, you know, when it comes to anything and everything that Allah has created, Allah is fully in charge. Nothing can come and benefit or increase or decrease that thing or that person, except if Allah allows that to happen. And anything that Allah allows that to happen has a greater wisdom. So in this thing, what we are saying is glory to my Rabb. Okay, this is really powerful to think about. You know, your connection with such a powerful one, such an amazing one, such a blessed one. And you are praying to him. You're having this one-on-one dialogue, right? So imagine, like, you know, if you have the opportunity to have a daily meeting one-on-one with, you know, the famous person or the person that you really, really like. Right. So, you know, whoever it is, whether it be an entrepreneur, a businessman, a scientist, an athlete, you know, how much we would care to be in their company and have a one-on-one dialogue with them. Remember, like, whose presence are we in? And we are bowing down to them, to him, subhanah, you know, glory be to him. And he is listening to us. We are praising him. We are having this one-on-one conversation and meeting with him. And then lastly, we say this Alvim, which means, you know, the magnificent, the great, the supreme. Okay, so this is really powerful as we think about it and to appreciate that he has given us the ability and blessed us with faith in him and has shown us how to worship him. So it's not something that we are inventing. This is how Allah taught his messenger, Muhammad, peace be upon him. And now we're using the same words. It's not a translation that we're using. We're using the words that Allah himself taught. So this is really, really amazing and powerful. Okay, so let's go into the spelling of it or the, you know, this pronunciation. So sub. Hana, Hana. Okay, my bad here. This should be capital R to have that heaviness. Rob, Subhana Rob, B, Yel. Okay, now here I have this thing apostrophe. Remember from the first video or second video, I was showing you this thing that kind of comes from the middle of the throat. Ah, so ah, and then you, I also showed you this thing there, which is the so it becomes Alvim, Alvim, Subhana Rabbi Alvim. So I hope that you find it beneficial. Till next time, Assalamu alaikum.